Hello, mga kapamilya. We are live at the newly opened VR Zone and Food Park at the Garage here in City of Dreams, Manila. Thank you so much for tuning in. My name is Angela C. I am the Associate Managing Editor of ABS-CBN Lifestyle and host of the Facebook Live series you're currently watching called Man Crush Monday. Now, in case you're wondering just what Man Crush Monday is all about, or if this is the first time you've come across Man Crush Monday, think of it as ABS-CBN Lifestyle's way of giving you guys the chance to get to know up-and-coming actors, models, singers, athletes, and influencers on a really personal level, all while getting to see them do something really fun at the same time. And because this is live, we invite all you guys to send in your questions and leave us comments as I bring out our man crush for the week. So this guy is a PBB 737 alum. He entered the famous Yellow House back in 2015 and came out as second big placer. And since then, he's gone on to pursue a showbiz career full throttle. He's appeared on TV series, he's modeled, and he's also done movies. In fact, he has a movie out right now called Three Words to Forever, where he stars alongside the greats such as Freddie Webb, Lisa Lorena, Joe Ross Gamboa, megastar Sharon Cuneta, Richard Gomez, and even Catherine Bernardo, in which his character plays fiancé to hers. So without further ado, here I give you our man crush for the week, Tommy Ascara. Hi, Tommy! Come out!
Hey, what's up?
What's up? So good to see you.
Good to see you.
Okay, so thank you first for giving or making time to come out here.
Of course. I heard we're going to go to the Garage, and I was super excited because I heard it's really fun out here.
So. Yeah, and I know you must be super busy because I know you're busy like promoting your movie, right?
Just a little busy. Just a little sleep deprived, but we're okay.
Yeah, okay. And I know that you're flying out to Dubai in a couple
days.
Yes,
in 2 days. 2 days we're flying out. Yeah, so we're doing Dubai in 2 days for 3 days, and then we'll be going to Hong Kong for promo. So
nice.
Very interesting. It's like a dream come true. I can't imagine. You know, this is the taste of those big actors, how their life is.
Yeah.
You know, so I can't imagine what they're like. I mean, I know Tita Sharon, she's 3 times as busy as me, and I'm exhausted, so I can't imagine what she's doing. So yeah.
Okay, so before you head back to all your promo work, we're gonna have a little fun, yeah, because we are here at the Garage.
Excited.
So you and I are gonna get to play games, and we're gonna
eat.
Let's
do that. Let's do it.
Yeah. So let's start. Ooh. Let's go.
Cool.
Yeah. Okay. So I know that this opened back in October. You and I get to test it out.
Okay.
So this is going to be our first stop.
I've been to a VR place before, but they've only had like the horror stuff.
Yeah.
Which was fun. I had a great time, but it was just one genre, you know? I can't wait to try the...
This one has, I believe, 3 kinds, but you and I are going to try out one of them, which is the Mario one.
I'm excited. Yeah. I used to play Mario Kart as a kid, so this is
going to be... Yeah, really?
Yes. Me and my brothers, I loved it. Let's do it.
Okay, so I think the Mario set is over here. Mm.
Yeah. Okay. Hello,
hello.
Hello. Hello, guys. Kumusta?
Thank you so much for having us.
Thank you.
So you can choose your character. We have Mario, Luigi, Princess Peach on the other side, and Yoshi.
Ooh, okay.
Okay.
You first.
Let's just say like together here. So
look at her. She's scared.
I'm clean.
She doesn't want me to have my best character. I knew it. Princess Peach, by the way. Okay.
Really?
So Mario, Luigi.
I'll take Mario.
All right. I'll take Luigi.
I'm a little tall. Hi, Matt.
So, Ate, how does this work?
Oh, what?
So, the pedal on your right is
hygienic, okay.
Accelerator.
Mm-hmm.
This one is the brake if you want to slow down.
Okay.
Ay, nako.
So,
my hair is going to mess up.
Use items floating with balloons. So, use your hands.
Okay, so welcome to
my room. How do I do this with my hair?
So, I'm in your hands like this. So use your hands.
This is a robbery.
The right pedal should grab.
Okay.
The turtle shell and the bananas, you can grab and throw it to him.
So he's my enemy. We're not working as a team.
It's a race. So your goal is to reach the finish line and aim for the first.
You gotta throw it.
Right.
So the turtle shell and bananas, you can throw it to him. But the hammer, you need to hold it. Use it to smash him.
Dumb?
To smash him. Okay.
So it's like literally grabbing objects, items.
So one is the hammer.
Using it to smash it.
That's another.
You can use it to smash your opponent.
So I guess I'll make this on as well.
Oh my gosh.
Right? And then the other two items, the turtle nutshell and the banana. So you can throw it.
I love this.
I'm so excited.
Okay, so,
right, so if you heal, these are your
okay, breaking gas. Drive. We're good. So, if you've ever played Mario Kart, you know that you drive a cart with other people on a map and you just go around the course. Now, you pick up items and you're able to shoot a turtle shell to hit the other drivers to slow them down and all this other stuff. But now, we have these, and instead of just pressing a button, I actually have to throw it. That's amazing.
Good.
Can't wait to try this.
Sorry, so I use this to punch?
Okay.
Just grab objects and throw.
Well, my hair
and the
is going
other
to be messed
hammer
up after
I can
this
use to smash it.
Yes.
Okay.
So you can do it in all directions. You can look behind you, you can throw objects behind you.
Okay.
Right, okay. So am I player one or player two?
You're gonna be player two.
So I'm going
your
to
your headphones, so your color green or
you can communicate with the other colors.
Look down on the handle.
Okay, is there a pedal? No?
Sorry.
Oh my
is
god.
There a pedal?
There.
Look down there.
Okay.
Face forward, turn, look down.
There. Good?
Alright.
This one is the brake on your left.
Brake is on my left. Okay. Tommy, are you ready?
Raise both hands, okay?
Where is she?
Ma, please look down.
Okay.
Alright. Can you look down on your
seat? Raise your hand.
Okay.
There. Good.
Raise your hand. Where are you?
Oh my goodness.
Look on your left, man.
You
ready
to lose?
Oh, I see you, Tommy, but you're on the opposite side of where I'm actually sitting.
Is that you?
Yeah. Oh my gosh. Here we go. Oh my god!
Oh shit, that's
wait, it hasn't started. Okay. Sorry.
That scared me.
Let's go! Oh my god!
Oh my gosh! Oh! This is intense! Oh my god, this is intense!
This is yes! Oh my god!
Oh my gosh!
We are being the driver!
Bye bye!
You are so ahead of me, but I am going to catch up!
I will see about that! Oh, watch out for the giant plant!
Oh
my gosh! Oh my god! Oh!
Whoa!
Okay. Are you okay back there?
Thank you for the concern. How are you doing, friend?
Oh no! I want to get an item so I can throw it. Oh.
It's like every second gets more and more intense.
I know, this is
crazy.
Is such a different experience. No, oh my god. Oh, there's the items. The items are here.
Okay, now we're flying. Now we're done. Now we have a ship.
Come on, give it to me. Give it to me.
You are so very much in front of me.
I didn't get one. I didn't get it.
Did you get anything?
Oh my gosh.
Nope. Okay.
Woo. Woo. Come on, give it to me. Give it to me. Oh my god, I got it.
Did you get hit?
Come here. Yo, this is crazy.
That was not a good move on my end.
Oh, what the?
Okay.
No.
Wow, this looks like hell.
Oh my gosh. This
it's
is
so
amazing.
Fiery.
Woo, woo. Woo. Oh, I see you, Luigi. All right.
Yep.
Okay.
Okay.
Wow, this is amazing. Give me that. Give me that.
Yeah.
No, give me that. Come on. Come here. Come here. Come here. Come here. Come here. Oh. How you like that?
I like that.
Oh, we'll see about that.
Just you wait!
Where are you at?
Just you wait!
Where are you at?
This race is not over!
Oh, you're lucky!
Oh, yeah!
Oh!
Oh, shoot! Okay, now I think it's over! Unless there's a round two! No?
Okay, that's Peach, Yoshi, Mario, and Luigi.
Wow, guys, that was extremely intense. I did not see that coming.
I loved it. I love that. I'm sorry, guys. I should have let the girl win, but I'm a competitive person.
I'm competitive too.
We were both like right before the finish line trying to hit each other with a hammer.
Yeah, I saw your hammer and like you were beating it.
That was so amazing.
That was crazy. Honestly,
you guys
should definitely check this out when you visit the
museum. It's crazy because this was moving and it actually felt like at first I was kind of like,
like, it was so difficult to balance,
and
to, like, control the steering.
Yeah, because I was really freaking out while we were driving. I was like, okay, I gotta keep it steady. That's fun. I enjoy that a lot.
Okay, before we proceed, we got a couple of questions that came in.
Okay.
So I'm gonna start with that. The first comes from, let's see, Gerardo Navarro.
Oh.
And he asks, I love your hair. How do you keep it that long and shiny?
Aw, well, thank you. Who's it, Jung Navarro?
Gerardo Navarro.
Gerard. I was like, wow, for your Jung. Thank you
for the compliment, and I just take care of it, you know, nothing too special, but every now and then, remember, oil is good. Some people like to think that they always have to shampoo their hair. That's not true,
because the oil that your head produces is actually healthy for your hair.
Yeah.
You know, so you don't want to shampoo every day, and you don't want to, you know, condition every other day. You know, I mean, like, just simple hair care routine, nothing too special.
Okay.
Yeah.
This next one came from Raf Hernante. Hi, Raf. He asks, who's your style inspiration?
Who's my style inspiration?
Yeah.
Beale Just.
Who?
Beale Just is a, go to Instagram, guys, and go at BIELJUSTE, and this guy is like an international model, and I love his feed, I love his look, I love his everything. Yeah.
Is he the inspiration behind your look right now?
No. This, I'm sorry, guys. This is my walang paki outfit. Like, this is just wake up and go play VR with friends. You know.
Yeah. Right. Okay.
This is my super casual outfit.
Let's proceed now to the food part.
Let's do our food part.
So you
let's
and I are going to get to eat.
I'm excited.
After a very intense round of VR.
Oof. Thank you guys. Thank you so much, huh? It was a lot of fun. I got to bring my friend here. This was very fun.
Yeah.
How much does it cost?
$450.
For one ride. What about for like a afternoon or an hour or something? Do you guys have it like? Wala ganyan. Sayang.
We have monthly activities for 1,200.
What is that?
It's a discount if you want to try the activities. It's not paying 40 p. It's only 1,200.
For four activities.
Okay.
Well, I'll bring my friend back, yeah?
How much ice cream do you
want? Okay. Oh, okay. So now we have the option of whether you want to do food first or if you want to play a round of...
Doesn't matter to me. Whatever you want to do.
But you're our guest. I'll let you decide.
It's okay. I feel bad after winning the game. You want some chocolate to help sweeten everything over?
Actually, how about another round there?
I don't want you to hate me, though.
No, I can't hate you.
Okay, let's do it.
Yeah, let's do
another round.
All right.
What is that? Ski board?
Ski board, apparently.
So this is...
Oh, sorry. Sorry about that.
Ski rodeo. Ah, oh my gosh, this one's standing. Let's see.
Okay, so welcome to Ski Rodeo. Okay.
Hello.
Very interesting.
Okay, you will ski down in a pristine snowy mountain. So the goal of this activity is to reach the bottom of the mountain within 2 minutes time. Okay? In case of emergency, if you want to stop, just squat down to say stop. So we have an emergency bottle so we can
stop!
Stop! Okay.
Okay.
Nice demo.
So during the activity, you need to insert your hand on the strap and hold the grip.
Okay. We're wearing this again, aren't we? This feels like I should wear this for the skiing.
Yeah.
Okay.
Alright, I gotta pull my hair back again. Give me all your money.
Okay, on how to ski, how to use your ski board. Do you want to go left or right? Just tilt your ski board.
Ooh.
Right or left. If it's a sharp turn, you have to twist.
Yeah, during sharp turn, you can... Yeah.
Oh, okay. This is going to be a
just
workout.
Tilt and then twist your ski board.
And then this
okay.
is the tilting?
Okay. Yeah.
Okay.
Gotcha.
Okay. So
ready?
Will we get to see what we're... Yeah. Or how far along we are?
Later after the game, you will see it on your time board. So in 2 minutes, you need to reach the bottom of the mountain. However, if you didn't reach it in the finish line at the end of the game, you will see how far you did.
Okay.
Yep.
Clear.
Clear.
Can you lift now? Can you try to tilt your feet?
Okay.
Oh, okay. So the tilting you can see when the snow kind of
it's like
moves.
RuneScape.
Yeah. You good?
Okay. Tommy, don't go easy on me. I'm a
again,
big girl. Hey,
what?
Don't go easy on me. I'm a big girl.
Don't go easy on you, huh?
No.
Okay. Ready?
Okay, sir.
Hello?
You have to insert your hands here on the strap. All right. And then hold the grip.
Hello.
Okay.
When you talk, mist comes out of your mouth.
This looks like the real thing.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, this is crazy.
Okay,
am I right?
Okay.
Do I get to see?
Yeah.
Like who I'm skiing
just
against?
Down.
No?
No.
Oh my.
Okay.
Okay. Okay, please forward, sir. Okay.
Oops.
Let's start. Okay.
Nope, alright.
Let's do this!
Okay.
I can hear you. Let's do it!
Woo!
Oh my god!
I'm being
so
wiped
scary.
Out!
Oh, I'm so scared!
This is intense!
Okay, come on, baby. We got this, we got this. Oh yeah, don't even worry about it.
Alright.
Woo!
Okay, I think I have to keep myself a little more steady.
Oh, I know I'm going fast. Jump!
Nope.
Hey! Oh yeah.
Are you done? I don't know how far along I've gotten. This is a little embarrassing. Okay. Alright. Huh. Let's see how far along this is
going to
be. Sharp turn. Woo! Oh, I'm about to hit the rocks. Ah, sharp turn pala yan.
Okay.
Okay. I thought I was supposed to go off.
Is this a sharp turn? Is this considered a sharp turn? Trying not to fall. But I'm about to hit a rock.
Okay, wow. Reach the goal. Very good. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
So that's round one?
The screen?
No!
The screen, you
it's
see
so
the red dots, that's you.
Okay.
That's how
okay.
far you did.
So,
Tommy did finish it in 1 minute and 28 seconds.
Ah, you know.
Good for you!
So we did 2 minutes time, pero iba di
na. Oh, sayang naman. It's so short. Bitin. That was a lot of fun, honestly.
Yeah.
That was a
very
lot.
Fun.
Bitin. I thought, I was like, oh, this is level 1, let's go, it's about to get crazy.
Yeah.
But then we finished, nah.
It's alright.
It was fun though. I enjoyed
it
a lot. It
was very fun though.
I was waiting for a ramp. I was like, okay, give me the ramp.
Yeah.
But that was fun.
I like the jumping parts.
Yeah, if they added little like buttons here, and then when you do a ramp, it'll like do flips. Mm-hmm. It'd be crazy.
Okay.
So I don't know. What was your time?
I didn't finish. I made it. I think like one third or one half. Oh. I'm not very good at balancing, but it was fun. I liked
it. It was fun though, huh?
Yeah. Oh,
it's unfair. That was an unfair.
It's all right. Unfair. I wanted to play this.
You did great though.
All right. Okay, so now we get to go to the food section.
Now we get to the food section. Let's do it.
So let's start.
I'm excited. What food are we eating?
I hope you're hungry too.
I am hungry. Even if I ate earlier, I'm hungry.
Good.
But what I think I saw a chocolate. What's going on there?
Yeah. I think that's right in front of us right now. I think we're going to like their chocolate shop. I don't know what exactly they have in store for us in there, but I guess you and I are going to be able to find out very soon.
Oh, I love chocolate.
You're not on a diet or anything, no. Are you?
Oh my gosh. I'm on the opposite of a diet.
Nice.
Eat
okay.
Anything I want.
And that's perfect because another question came in asking something similar to it. So this one's from Aliana Tolentino, and she asks, what are your tips on staying sexy during Christmas?
Eat as much as you can. Then you just get like thick and sexy. No, honestly, just, you know, if you're not active, then cut back on the calories. And that's anything. You can just skip a meal, or you can just not eat as much every meal, or do whatever it is. Drink more water. It makes you feel more full. So you trick your brain into, because most of the time you think you're hungry, but yeah, you're actually thirsty, or your body, like water can feel that craving, you know? So
yeah,
there's so many ways to just kind of take away calories, and you don't necessarily have to work out every day. You know what I mean?
So, how often would you say you work out?
Every day.
Ever? Okay.
You don't have to work out every day. I do, but you don't have to, you know?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, I have a gym in my place, so.
Oh, so it makes it convenient for you.
Very convenient. I wake up and I go out and there's my gym, so, yeah.
So it doesn't make you feel bad when you go to, like, places like this and you can eat whatever?
Yeah, no, I eat whatever. Yeah.
Nice.
Yeah, okay. I feel, yeah. Every now and then I'll have a little tummy happening and then I'm like, okay. All right, no more McDonald's for, no more burgers for a week. Yeah, no brands here. No more.
It's fine.
No more burgers for a week, so yeah.
All right, so let's go in.
Let's do it. This is the chocolate place,
yes,
isn't it?
Ooh. Oh, wow.
Please,
if you
tell
guys
me
look
I get
at this
to
place,
take
it's
one of
full
these
of
home.
Like Christmas themed chocolate. I'm already excited.
These,
I hope
oh
you
my
are
god,
too.
What are these?
Ooh.
Is this a much? Hello.
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 Sarah.
Nice to meet you.
Hi, welcome. So you want to taste the chocolate?
Yes.
Yes, please.
Not even waiting. Let's see. Oh my
so
god.
So you can choose in the six styles.
What is this? Raisin?
No, this is a berry.
Cranberry?
Oh, it's like coke.
Yes.
Oh my gosh.
Oh my gosh.
Can we get like a taste of each?
Okay.
Can I just get a big one of the full bars? Take it home then.
Okay.
Start off with it.
No, of course.
I insist.
No, go. You first. You let me know how it is. You'll be my taste tester.
Okay. So I'll be the guinea pig, and if basically something happens to me, then you already know it.
Tommy, you?
Yes. Yes, please. Oh, yeah. That's
very good.
After that, mm-hmm, I think I'm going to have to get one.
This is the face of approval.
Ooh.
So that one actually is a white chocolate.
Mm.
This one is a cashew mango.
I'm sorry, cashew mango?
Yes. And the base is milk chocolate. While the other one is white chocolate.
That is so good.
Thank you.
Such a rich chocolate.
Mm-hmm.
And that chef over there is our chocolatier.
Oh my god.
She's responsible for doing all this chocolate here.
Imagine
guys,
how
look how intense the chocolate making is here. They made flowers.
I love it.
Mm-hmm. We're not even tasting it, and it already looks good.
These flakes of leaves of vanilla chocolate must be amazing. They must melt in your mouth. Can I just get that brick, though?
Which one?
Just the brick.
Is that fully cooked already?
I'll take it, you know?
Raw?
Yeah. Well, all of the chocolates here, if you can see the chocolate.
I'm still eating.
What other chocolates do you have that we can try?
As you can see over there.
most of that one. Mm. This one or white chocolate, milk chocolate, and
thank you.
The dark chocolate.
Mm. Oh, thank you. She saw me from a mile away struggling.
Yeah.
I want some more chocolate.
Do you?
Mm-hmm. Oh, no, we'll keep going.
Okay. Let's go to the next part of the food park here.
Oh, I have to buy some stuff after this.
Mm-hmm.
Is that brick chocolate? Is that chocolate brick?
Yes.
Are those mice on the on the bricks?
Mm-hmm. Mm.
Everything here is edible. Even the display over there, all edible.
Oh my gosh.
Imagine if you were just like...
I would just be sitting in my room with literally a brick and just eating the chocolate.
Yeah,
know?
Right? That sounds like a dream.
Oh my god. That was delicious.
Okay.
So the next stop is we have the coffee shop, which we call the Roaster.
Coffee?
Sure.
Let's do it.
You
that
take
cashew,
coffee?
I just got the cashew and it's so good.
Mm-hmm.
Guys, the best chocolate ever. Oh
thank
my
you.
Gosh. I'm
if Tommy likes it, you gotta check it out.
I'm such a sweet tooth.
So
okay, let's do
really
this.
Order some coffee.
Hello.
Hi. We have over ice, we also have the tea.
What do you recommend?
For me, it depends. Do you want hot or cold?
You.
You want an over ice?
I'll get
an
ice, yeah.
For the over ice, our specialty is cafe condensada and cafe caramel.
Cafe condensada. Is that condensed milk?
Yes.
I've never had that in coffee.
Oh, really?
We're getting that.
Yeah.
Yeah, you getting it?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
That sounds really good.
My family has a shaved ice business back home in California,
mm-hmm.
and we worked it like ever since the beginning, and we put condensed milk on top of the shaved ice, and it's the best thing ever. You
nice.
Would love it, honestly. But I've never had it in coffee, so that sounds like it's interesting.
Neither have I. Like, when I think condensed milk, I usually think it's something that you place on dessert.
Yeah.
Let's see how it
did you ever used to eat the condensed milk out with a spoon?
Yes.
I would
that was the first time I ever tried it.
I will get diabetes for that. You know, I don't even care. No fear, you know?
Yeah, totally worth it. Okay.
Well, while we're
while we're waiting, I guess we can go check out some of the other
stalls that
this food park has.
Perfect.
Okay, I wonder where they're taking us now
because there seems to be
a big variety of food here.
I'm loving it. I didn't know that City of Dreams has all this.
Me too.
So the first container van is what we call the juice, which we serve only healthy drinks.
Oh.
The smoothies, the slushies, and detox.
Oh, detox.
Yeah. And then here we have the Hokkaido ramen, which we call Sentoka. They serve classic ramen, which is basically special in Macau.
I love ramen.
Makati?
No.
The
world famous Makati ramen.
Actually, yes.
Makati.
And then this one, we have the Kasutsura. Unfortunately, it's their Christmas party today, so we're gonna try this one.
Is that the one with the little balls?
Yes.
Ah, yeah. The little pancakes.
Those are really good.
Yeah, I know. They're so light too,
and
no?
Then we have the
El
Chupacabra.
Ah,
oh yes.
You know. Oh, this is it. Oh.
Oh, there's food already.
Have you ever been to El Chupacabra?
I have.
Oh my god. You already
know. It never gets old. Have you?
Okay, you go first. I love El Chupacabra.
No, have you tried it?
Yes.
Already? Okay.
Because I'm from California, so Mexican food is our forte.
Yes. That's
so very true. I love Mexican food. But there's only very few places that do it well. In Philippines, I don't know what it is, you know.
But this is one of them, you would say.
Yeah, I found a couple better, but this is one of them. The famous Makati Chupacabra. Actually, yeah, because that's where everyone knows it from. Makati, no?
Yeah, I think so.
So you don't want something now.
You go
first.
Can
I take this? Okay, because if not, I'll take it.
Yeah, please.
Okay, let's get a little.
So what is this out there? What exactly?
And this one is.
Is that a woo because it's spicy?
Oh no,
or is
I accidentally dipped my finger in this,
okay.
And then I ate it. It was really spicy.
verdict.
Thumbs up.
I'm good.
Anthony, like, can we take this to go?
Yes.
Thank you.
I see a taco
then,
there. Is that included as well?
Yes.
I'll take that to go as well.
Okay. Alright. So now we're going to continue on our little journey. Ade, what is next for us?
I ate this earlier. Right? I ate this earlier. It was good. You, did you try it?
Not yet.
Yo, their best pizza is actually delicious.
Which one is the best one? What was that?
This one is their bestseller, the Cuatro, for Maggie, which is actually four cheeses.
And wait, that's not what I had. This one.
This one, right?
The prosciutto arugula. It's a black ink.
Yeah.
But it's,
that was good.
That's their bestseller.
Yeah. Both of these sound amazing, honestly. I'll come back and I'll get this.
Okay.
Okay.
And the next one is...
Oh, pink wrappings? There
yeah.
we go.
You're from California, right?
Yeah.
Hollywood.
Yep. Oh my gosh.
Reminds you of home?
Oh yes, I love pinks. Because it's a real hot dog with all the condiments. Yeah. Like, you know how they have those places that they're like, wow, artisan hot dogs. It's like, I don't want an artisan hot dog. I don't want a hot dog
yeah,
that looks fancy.
Yeah, people just want it like plain. And
I want something that it can have a lot of stuff, but I don't care about it looking nice, yeah. You know? We just put in everything and then eat it. But like, sometimes you'll see hot dogs are like, oh, they put all this design and all. I'm like, don't even worry about that. Just give me a hot dog with
oak. So now you get to try their hot dog.
Well,
oh my gosh. Wow, this is a very grammable hot dog.
That is
say.
A big hot dog.
I have never seen a hot dog with egg on it either.
And it's actually into. Oh, I want my phone. Can I take a photo? I want to take a photo of this.
Oh my goodness.
Okay.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh. And then. Again. Ah, perfect.
Perfect.
Okay,
take
Thank
the
you.
First bite.
Okay, I'm the first bite. okay, wait. Oh my gosh.
No judgment. Ad has got a bunch
it
of tissue just in case.
Though.
Oh my god. Do they taste just as good as the ones back in California? Nice.
It's kind of hard to eat, but it is delicious.
All right.
You just have to find the right.
Oh, yeah.
It's good, huh?
Mm-hmm.
You do have to get... Can I take this to go?
Yes, can.
I'm taking everything. And I'm collecting napkins from all the places. Mm-hmm. It's like my new hobby.
Maybe it's a souvenir.
It's a souvenir.
Okay.
Okay.
Before we move on, some more questions came in.
Mm-hmm.
So, this one comes from Louis Penn. He asks, what's your favorite Christmas memory? Oh, a lot of people ask
favorite
about Christmas.
Favorite Christmas memory, huh? That's a hard one.
We're back live on Man Crush Monday. We do apologize for some technical difficulties that came up as we were airing, but we're back now, and we are still here with the one and only Tommy Esguerra.
Wow, hello guys. We're back.
We're back. So we're going to be continuing our tour of this food park here at the garage.
At the garage
of the City of Dreams, Manila. But before we continue, we got a couple of questions that came in for Tommy, so I'm going to ask them.
Okay, let's do it.
Okay. This next one comes from Nikki Howe.
Uh-huh.
Hi, Nikki. She asks, what are your plans this Christmas? And do you have someone special to spend it with?
Okay, what are my plans this Christmas? So, I might be spending it with my tita.
It depends on whether or not it's going to pull through. And if not, then I'm spending it with my Lola and my friends from the States. My friend from the States. My best friend from the States is staying with me here. So I'll probably spend it with him.
Great. Okay, that sounds really fun.
Yeah, it's going to be fun. Either way, whatever happens, yeah.
Yeah. All right. So we have one more question that came in. This is from Angelo Pangilinan.
Oh, Pangilinan. Why does everyone have like artist last names? You know, earlier
right?
It was Argento Navarro.
No, yeah, Gerardo Navarro.
Pangilinan. I'm like, okay.
All right. This one, or in this one, he asks, "What's the greatest lesson about love you have learned so far?"
Ooh, yeah, that's a good one. The greatest lesson about love. I always used to think, not that it was cliche, I knew that it had merits, but when people would say, you have to love yourself in order to love others, I used to be like, yeah, it's just things people say, you know, or
yeah.
There's merit, but whatever. But I just recently actually learned this firsthand that, you know, if you don't take care of yourself and if you don't love yourself, then yeah, you can't possibly make other people happy. You know what I mean? Or you can't, you know what I mean? Like, you have to think about you first and then you can think about others.
Yeah.
Because, yeah.
That's like a proof or true selflessness.
Yeah, so yeah.
Okay, so we're gonna continue on. Like,
let's
checking out the food
do
park.
It. So last place we ate was Pink's.
Yes, and now we are at Little Flower.
Which is...
I've never heard of Little Flower before.
It's actually a Filipino cuisine. These are Filipino cuisine.
Oh, do they have samples for us?
They can.
Oh man,
okay.
Everyone.
So we just gotta come back here.
We gotta come back. We'll come back after the table.
Right. Yeah. What's the next stop?
This one is a pharmacy.
Oh, okay. Now this we probably
you
don't
know
really
have
to wait for,
that's a,
right?
You know
all
they
right.
have samples for. There, look at that. It's already ready.
Yeah.
Oh my goodness.
Well, hello.
Lord.
Oh my gosh. Do you like chocolate?
Yes. Do you like chocolate?
I love
we
chocolate.
Just came from the chocolate bar. That wasn't evident
it's
enough.
It's not enough. We need more chocolate.
Yeah.
Yeah. We're
going to
need
more.
Chocolate
they have a bunch
from the chocolate
of toppings.
Bar and then this chocolate. Just
oh
put
my
it together.
Goodness.
Okay, let's do it.
Okay,
this
let's start off with this though.
Oh my gosh.
Oh my gosh. It looks good already. One, two.
I'm too excited. I'm
no, you just
like,
went
one, two. Okay.
Yep.
One,
right.
two, three, go.
Mmm. Amazing.
So
yeah.
good. It is so good.
So good, I need a second
scoop. Oh my gosh.
Yeah. Pharmacy does not fail. What other flavors do you have here?
This one they have vanilla, strawberry ice cream, chocolate, caramel, strawberry, mango, coconut. They have a lot actually.
Do you guys have any to go?
At this point I think you should get things to go from each one of
that
these.
That is the plan. You gotta catch
yep.
them all, you know, Pokemon. So that's a yes? They're laughing, but I'm serious.
Okay, I think we can take this ice cream and...
Yeah.
Thank you.
Let's go to the next stop.
So good.
Or if not the next stop, back to the coffee, maybe?
Yes.
Oh, yeah. Oh, we have
Yeah,
coffee.
Because we ordered coffee earlier, in case you missed it.
It has condensed milk.
Yes, coffee with condensed milk. Something that Tommy and I have not tried yet.
But if we put the condensed milk on the
with
ice cream,
oh man.
I don't know.
It's going to be like heaven in one, two cups.
I know. We'll talk to the chocolate people, tell them to make us a spoon out of chocolate, right? And then...
We have the bar, which they serve signature cocktails.
Oh,
cocktails.
I don't drink alcohol. It's okay.
So we go back to
Devil's. Mm.
Mm-hmm.
Yep, too good.
This is so good. Like it's.
Where we roast our own coffee. coffee
bean. That looks intense.
That's what I'm saying.
You can go inside. You can
we can go inside?
Oh my god.
Oh wow.
That's good.
This is exciting.
I know.
Can I roast my ice cream?
It smells like the most amazing coffee.
Oh my god. Oh, it's warm.
It's warm because they just roast their coffee.
That is crazy. Look at this thing.
How often is this machine used? Is it running like 24/7?
This one can roast like actually 5 kilos per roast. So
5 kilos per roast. So they just throw it in there.
Yeah. Is that 5 kilos worth of beans? Or is that more? I'm not very good at measuring.
I know, especially with the bigger amounts.
Right.
Plus, I'm not good with the metric system. I'm from America where we just use the... I so bad when I put my hand.
Maybe.
Start like moving around.
Wow.
Oh my gosh, that smells so great.
Do you drink coffee like on a regular basis?
I purposely have to stop myself from drinking coffee.
Really?
Yes, I have to really put some discipline in that. So I drink a lot of water. Mm-hmm. Water is such a sad life. You want to lose weight, drink water. You want to stop drinking coffee, drink water.
How much coffee would you say you've
done? Oh my gosh. I mean, the thing is with how busy we are, like right now, I've slept like 3 hours. And that's normal, you know?
Mm-hmm.
And easily in one day of working, I can drink like 10, 12 cups of coffee.
Wow. Mm-hmm. Intense.
It came to a point where I'll wake up, won't even have breakfast, and that's, you know, coffee will be a lot stronger because you just woke up and you haven't eaten, right?
Mm-hmm.
But I'm so used to it now that I could drink 3 coffees before breakfast. And I was like, okay, this is a problem, you know, I need to stop this. So, yeah, I just drink coffee still, but I limit it.
All right. Okay, before we get our coffee, which I can see, I don't know if you can see it from where we're standing.
Oh! What is the jelly?
Yeah, apparently there's jelly. But before we get into that, let's get you to answer a couple of questions that mm-hmm. came in. So this next one comes from Matthew Moncada.
Moncada.
He asks, "Kumusta po katrabaho ang aming Teen Queen and what can we expect from you two soon?"
Aming Teen Queen?
Teen Queen.
Teen Queen.
Sorry, I have like Teen an accent too when I speak. Yeah.
Ako?
Yeah.
Teen Queen?
Catherine, or Queen of Hearts.
I thought me. Teen
no!
Queen. I was like, what?
Like, how is it like working with Catherine? And what can
it's,
you
it's
as
amazing.
Expect in your new movie?
It's amazing. Like, so, I mean, we all know that she's the Teen Queen, you know?
Yeah.
But it's, and I've watched her movies, I thought she was great, but it's until I've worked with her and I saw it firsthand up close how amazing she is, you know? I mean, she's a grade A actress. We had so many scenes where it's like, the director's like, okay, we're gonna do the setting up the scene. It's like, okay, Catherine, make sure you cry here, on right at this point, cry, and then keep going,
yeah.
And then we do the scene, and she's crying, and I'm just like, what? How do you do that?
Cry on
you know?
Cue.
She's amazing, like, she really is in tune with her emotions. She's really sweet as well, and she was very understanding because I needed a few more takes than everyone else. So
that's nice. Mm-hmm. Okay, I honestly don't want to wait any longer for the coffee, so let's go.
Let's do it.
Let's do it.
I'm gonna be on a sugar rush after
yes.
this.
Yes, that is the point.
This is so cool.
Yeah,
have you,
right.
Have you ever seen the chestnut roasting?
I have not.
Yeah, it's like that almost, that little, that area right there where it just keeps turning.
Mm-hmm.
It's really interesting. Oh, this is so cute. I love it.
Wow.
Okay, let's have our...
Thank you. I wasn't expecting a glass this tall, though,
I
between
wasn't.
You and me.
Yeah.
I thought it would be maybe like
I
half
mean,
the size.
One,
yeah,
you know?
This is like a generous serving.
It's interesting, the jelly, because I've never had coffee with jelly.
But you've tried coffee jelly before? Like,
I've
like as a dessert?
It, I think they threw it in halo halo once,
mm-hmm.
or some sort of ice cream, maybe.
Yeah, this is such a unique concept.
I like it. Is this the condensed milk?
Yeah, I believe the condensed milk is right at the bottom.
Oh my god.
Yeah, this has to be the coffee, no doubt.
That is so much condensed milk. I love it. I need to see if that's condensed milk. We have to figure this out. If it is, I'm gonna... Oh wait.
Are you gonna like dip it and then try to taste the milk from there?
I don't know if that's okay. Because if it was condensed milk, maybe it's just not as thick.
Or maybe because it's too mixed in with the coffee, it's already...
Oh, here, let me get you a... Oh. There we go. Would you like to try a jelly?
It would be my pleasure. But I got my own spoon. So I will try with you.
Nope, you're trying.
Nope, all right, nope. Even better.
Taste test my guinea pig. How is it?
Well, I'm not dead yet.
Okay, then I guess I
but it's good. It's actually really good.
Oh, the ice. It's good. That is good. Coffee jelly. It's actually coffee, isn't it?
I think so. Just actually, in the jelly form.
Yeah, right? Mm-hmm. Like, it's not like it's just, they just call it coffee jelly, but it's actually coffee.
I'm no food expert, but...
That's good.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure that's it.
This is interesting because people have coffee dates a lot, and it's like a coffee date and a dessert date together, you know?
Yeah, so it's 2-in-1.
I like it. It's really nice.
This is really good. Okay, before I get carried away though with the coffee, I'm gonna ask you a couple more questions that came in. Yeah. All right. We have two questions that came from Kimberly Aurelio.
Kimberly Aurelio. Okay.
Yeah. Okay, the first one is, let me see if I can zoom it in. Is there anything you wanted fans to know about you when you shot BBB? And number two, what lesson did you learn from your latest movie that you'll want to apply to future projects?
Okay, so is there something I wanted my fans to know?
Yeah.
I shot BBB?
Mm-hmm.
Well, like, when I was in the house in BBB, I had no idea if I had fans. So, because you don't know. When you're in the house, you're disconnected from the outside world.
Yeah.
So, I wasn't sure if I did, but... The few fans I did have, like maybe one or two, before I was even in showbiz. I guess when I was on PBB, my goal was to just be me, you know, be me, completely unhinged, no holding back, no being shy. You know what I mean? Because this is my one opportunity to let people know who I am. And if they like, my idea behind it was that if they like me, then they like me. But if not, I'm not gonna live a life of just trying to please other people and not being me, you know?
Yeah.
Like, I don't wanna be the artista, an artist that just, you know what I mean? Like, I didn't wanna
like, you don't wanna be
put
fake.
On the front, because I can't live like that. I would die.
Yeah.
You know, from the stress or from whatever, I need to be.
It seems so taxing also to
exactly,
do that.
Exactly, very taxing. And, so that, I guess, was my goal, to just put myself out there and see what people think. And people liked it, you know? But, of course, that does come with its own issues, because when you're completely you and you're not always watching out and trying to get the best answer, you can make mistakes, you know? And I definitely make mistakes.
We're all human.
Yeah, and I make mistakes left and right, and people made sure I knew, you know? Which kind of sucks. Like, some people just don't want to let things go. But overall, I'm still happy with how it turned out. What else? What was the other question?
What lessons have you learned from shooting Three Words to Forever that you're going to apply to future movies or projects?
What lessons did I learn? My biggest lesson I think I've learned was... hard. I learned a lot during the taping, but I learned a lot from the director, I learned a lot from Keitha Sharon, and Joel Rose taught me a lot, but I would say I learned the most from the director, because she helped me
hit those really heavy scenes where I'm really hurt or I'm really sad or I'm pissed off or mad, sorry.
Yeah.
And she helped me get in touch with those emotions that I needed so that I can portray that scene as well as I could. And I think that's what's going to stick with me the most. That and just, I learned 1,000 things while I was there, you know? It really was a great experience.
Okay. So that's it for today's episode of Man Crush Monday. Thank you so much to everyone who tuned in. For updates on Tommy and our Man Crush Monday series, you can check us out on our Facebook or on our website. That's www.lifestyle.abs-cbn.com. You can also check us out on our Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and YouTube pages. That's at ABS-CBN Lifestyle. Special thanks to City of Dreams for having us. Special thanks as well to Angelito, Panginiban, and Arnie. Wait, I will get the names.
Yeah, I know. I was thinking.
Yeah, exactly. Oh, it's right here. Perfect. Arnie Balantad of Makeup Design Academy for our hair and makeup. So if you missed any part of today's episode, just refer to this link and click back on the rewind button to watch from the beginning. And stick around because we have a lot more man crushes coming up for you in the coming weeks. So thanks again for watching. Thank you, Tommy.
Thank
it's so
you.
Much fun with
Thank
you.
You. I had a great time. I had a great day. Yeah.
Great day.
Thank
Bye,
you, guys.
Guys.